I'm gonna inlay this film into this film. So, make sure my reins aren't twisted. All this lovely chaz. I'm so stiff, my back still hurts. I did lunge her, as you saw. So hopefully she'll be well behaved. No guarantees, of course. I feel like I gained 500 pounds over the winter too, so. Can't be fully mad at her for being fat. Mommy gained some poundage too. So. As you can see, my footing isn't the best, and a lot of rocks came up this year again. And if you remember from my older videos, I actually had to de-rock my whole arena at one point, and it took a very long time to do. So now I have to do this all over again, which really sucks. But what you gonna do? It's kind of slick through here. I hate riding in mud, but if I don't ride, she's never going to get conditioned for the paces this year, and then I'm going to just be SOL when it comes to doing anything. So, hopefully she'll just behave herself and not be stupid. Like she likes to be every now and then. I did groom her. I missed a couple of spots on her face up here. But that's okay. I don't think I'm going to ride down here. It seems to be slicker downhill. Maybe I'll ride down here when I pop over the little log right there. That's only about a foot. It's good for first jumping of the year, kind of conditioning-wise. But the rest of the footing here is horrible. This is why I wish I had, like, an outdoor footing. And I think I'm going to get footing this year. I mean, I try to be, like, all natural and let the grass and stuff grow. But this year it's just been bad. Not to mention the horse has been on it, so that doesn't help. So we will see. Sassy trot. So we're just gonna keep a circle down here. I'm gonna have her give to her bit, put my leg on her so she bends through her rib cage. There we go. And this is what I'm looking for. I'm looking for her to give to her bit, round through her rib cage. And this does hurt my back something fierce, but I think it's good for my back muscles too. So I'm gonna kinda go with the pain here. I'm gonna keep my inside rein a give and take, half halts, just to get her to drop her nose like she is here. And then I'm gonna keep my outside rein steady, and that's gonna help her bend a little bit better through her inside. So, since she has been laid off, this is gonna be a big workout for her because she hasn't really been ridden this winter at all. And she's trying to cut into this corner here, so I'm gonna give her a little bit more leg. And my leg muscles are burning already. And like I said, when you don't ride, you get out of shape too. So you can't just rely on your horse to do everything for you. There, that's a nice bend. She's working nicely through her top line. I can feel her push off with her back end. And the way you're gonna feel that on your horse, if your horse is very hollow, the first time you feel them round out, it's going to feel like a balloon coming up through your butt. You're going to feel yourself at least an inch taller in the saddle. Good girl. Good. And she's kind of tilting towards the inside of her circle. So I'm going to lift up with my inside rein just a little bit over her shoulder. This is going to help lift that shoulder so she's not going to drop it too far into that circle. See? You're gonna help your horse help itself. Good girl. Good. And I'm still gonna keep my inside leg on her because I don't want her resting against my inside leg. So I'm gonna give her bumps here and there. She is coughing. She has dust allergies. Good. And walk. And we're gonna do that on and off. We're gonna let her relax, stretch through her top line, these muscles up here. And that's gonna help her loosen all that winter fat that she gained. Now, if you've ever gotten onto one of those little vibrating thingies that you stick around your waist and it jiggles you around, you know, how much that itches? That happens to horses, too. So if you ever notice that your horse starts shaking itself more or they get really antsy, it's because they're itching. So you want to be able to rub it out a little bit, especially where the saddle sits. That way it kind of helps them relax a little bit. So we're going to do a nice quarter turn in our circle to go the other way. And we're going to do the same thing. I'm going to keep my inside rein a little bit shorter with a nice half halt. Keep my outside rein taut just so that she can't turn into a circle. I'm going to put my inside leg on her. Ask for a nice trot. T-Rot says. And I'm going to ask her to drop her head the same way I did before. Good. And you're going to try to relax your hip at the same time. As you see, I'm not posting because I'm driving my seat into the saddle. I want to drive her mostly with my seat and not my legs. Now, my legs are a little weaker because, again, I haven't ridden all winter. So I'm trying to use my leg muscles, in a sense, as bumping her out of the circle, okay? So while I'm bumping, I'm still trying to get her to move forward. Now she's kind of cutting the corners here. She's trying to get really deep. I'm going to give her a stronger half halt on the outside rein because I don't want her to run out. And she likes to run out on this side because this is her bad shoulder. So I'm going to kind of funnel my legs against her. There. Good. There we go. See how she's kind of bending her neck? Good. I don't want to feel too much of her mouth in my hands, especially with this bit. You can't really balance with this bit because you'll rip the jaw off. So this bit is good for advanced riders just because it teaches you to be a little bit more giving in your hands. And she's coughing out all that winter dirt is what I call, but she is kind of asthmatic when it comes to dust and she hasn't really been ridden, so she'll be doing this for a while. And she's trying to take the reins. She likes to roach a lot, which is fine. I'm gonna let her do that just because I know she's stretching her top line. As long as she's soft in my hands. The minute she starts getting rude about it, I'm not gonna give her the head anymore. There. I want her to really work through her top line. There, working through her back. Really reaching, getting round. Good girl. A little bit of a slip there, that's fine. I don't want her to be heavy on her forehand, especially in muddy conditions. If you have a pace horse or a cross-country horse that you do eventing on, you definitely don't want them to be heavy on the forehand because that causes a lot of issues. They can get in trouble, they could run out on a jump, they can fall after a jump. So you definitely want to be able to have them rock back. There, good girl. And walk. Good. So, there we go. Now, I do praise my horse. I give her a rub, I give her two pats. I don't smack my horse. Again, like I mentioned yesterday in the video, horses don't like being smacked. But you do definitely want to pat them down. Give them a good praise for doing a good job. Release in here is the walk after a trot. You're, you know, releasing the forward command so they can relax a little bit. I'm going to ask her to drop her head here in a penny roller stretch. Good. And how I'm doing this is I'm give and taking from both sides of the rein. And I'm pushing her forward with my seat. Good. I want her to walk into the bit. I don't want to constrict her head. I don't want to pull the bit into her because that's counterproductive. I don't want to do an artificial collection. I want her to be able to round out naturally, go into the bit, reach into the bit, look for the bit, because that tells me that she's actually paying attention. So I'm going to stop her here with my seat. Ooh. Ooh. Good. And I'm going to ask her for a turn on the forehand. Nice and soft. Wonderful. Good girl. And with a turn on the forehand, as you notice, I do put my rein over the neck, and I ask her with my leg to turn around her back end. And this is gonna open her shoulders, get rid of all that winter rust, because we don't want that winter rust in there. There, now she's really stretching. My dog's a pain in the ass. Sorry for that little word right there, but he is. He's a PITA. I'm gonna stop her here. Ooh, good. And I'm gonna ask her to turn on the forearm the other direction. Rein up over the shoulder to lift the shoulder, leg on. Good girl. You see how she's really reaching down? Now, like I said, she does roach, and she does that out of habit, which is fine. Now, I'm not gonna be cantering on this ground just because it is kind of slick. There. Good girl. So we're gonna get to the other part, and then I'm gonna ask her to back. And I haven't done any rearing under command for a while, so she shouldn't do it. Again, the rearing is a different command altogether, but sometimes she just likes to do it just because. So I'm gonna stop her. Ooh. There we go. Ooh. I'm gonna ask her to back. Sassy, back. A little bit of tension, and release when she backs up. Back, a little bit of tension, release. Good, and back. Good. Now normally I don't want her to pop her head up, so I'm gonna push her into her bit again. There. Good girl. So, we're gonna pop over this little jump here. I'm not doing a lot today with her just because she is kind of out of condition here. And I don't want to tense up any muscles unless I have to, because that'll just make her sore for the next time. Tucker, don't be nasty. What are you eating? I swear that dog is disgusting. So I'm gonna ask her to trot. I'm not gonna trot too far down her because it gets a lot slicker. So I'm gonna just trot her down a little bit. And I'm gonna walk her towards this jump and pick up the trot a little bit ahead of the jump. So I'm gonna scope my jump. As a jumper, you need to make sure you know where your jump is. Good girl. And here I'm just going to practice on my seat. Sassy is kind of a one-way shoot pony. You aim, she goes, you sit pretty, and you focus on yourself. So I'm going to make sure that my leg is there. Again, haven't ridden in a while. I don't want my leg to slide back. I don't want it to slide forward. I don't want to be ahead of the horse. I don't want to be behind the horse. I want to be right when she takes off. So I'm going to wait. I'm going to wait till I feel her round out from behind. And then I'm going to go into my 2-point. And granted, this is a smaller jump. And even with my 2-point, I want to make sure I'm not holding onto the reins tight. Because again, this bit is not something you're going to ride in if you have loose hands. Now she sped up there a little bit. And I don't want her getting used to just running straight for the jump. She has a bad habit of wanting to rush jumps. It's because she is a confident horse. You can take her cross-country jumping and she will jump almost anything you point her at, and she won't refuse a jump. I'd say 9 out of 10 times she won't refuse a jump. There are occasions where she will run out, and she does that because she's testing. It's not because she's scared of anything. So I'm going to give her a really strong half halt in front of this jump to emphasize that I just want to trot it. Half halt. Good. And again, I am not pulling on my reins over the jump. I'm giving her a good release, not too much of a release, but enough of a release where that if I need to hold her back, because she does have a tendency to bolt sometimes after the jump, she's not going to take off on me and start bucking, because she does have a habit of doing that too. So I'm going to move her over with my leg. I don't want her cutting in. I'm going to look at my jump. I already picked out where my takeoff point is, but I let Sassy decide where she's going to take off, just because I want her to be safe that way. Half halt. Good. Now, she did kind of kick that with her front legs. That tells me I was a little bit ahead of the motion, so I'm going to try to wait a little longer. I do have a habit of trying to jump ahead of my horse, and that's very dangerous, especially for cross-country, because if you land in a cross-country jump that's solid, you can break your neck, your collarbone, your back, can even kill you. So you don't want to make a habit of jumping ahead of your horse. And I've learned because I chumped Percy for a long time, that I kind of lost confidence in chumming when he started stopping. Good. That was perfect. Good girl. There. So, now I'm going to just not do any more chumps, but we're going to start asking for her to do side passing, give to the leg pressure a little bit better. So I'm going to do a nice little trot circle. Good girl. Come on. And I know I'm kind of getting out of frame here. I don't think I have my camera set up. I'm going to ask her to drop her head. Good. Good girl, drop your head. There. Now I'm going to slow her down here because she hasn't done this all winter. I'm going to ask her to turn towards the middle and I'm going to put my leg on her. And she's kind of overbending. She's not really giving me her back end at all. So I'm going to try to slow her down, take more of the outside. There. Good. See, what happened there is if she tries to just cross over with her front and not her back, she's kind of overbending in that sense because she's not working through her whole body. She's only working through half of it. So what I did is I slowed her down. I closed the door on the outside a little bit more so that she did not have that option to cut out. And she had to kind of line her body up a little bit better to give me that nice side pass. Now, Sassy was never good at half passes. It got worse when she injured herself. She wasn't able to do that. So I don't really try it with her because I know it hurts a little bit more. So I'm going to ask for this side. This side's a lot better, as you can see. She's still kind of overbending a little bit. I'm going to take the thing away. You see how she's kind of bending her body? I want her to move forward. Forward. There. Much better. Now with a side pass, if you're new to it, you're only going to ask for one or two steps. And the best way to do it is find a solid wall, either your arena fencing or the wall of the indoor, and line your horse up vertically towards it, and then just ask him to move over one step. Okay, you're not going to ask him for like five steps right off the gung-ho. You're going to ask him for one step, and you're going to call it good. And you're going to do that from both sides, probably two or three times on both sides, and you're going to be good and just continue doing what you were doing. You don't want to overdo it. So now I'm going to open her shoulders up a little bit. I'm going to ask her to trot. I'm going to ask her to give me her head. We're going to go around the jump, and I'm going to ask her to side pass in a trot. I don't know if she's going to do it because the footing is bad. And she slowed down, which is fine, but I'm going to ask her to do it anyways. Even if she slows down. Good girl. And I'm only going to ask her as much as I think she can do. I'm not going to over-ask my horse. Because again, she's not fit. She hasn't been ridden all winter. So that would just be mean of me. I'm like, hey, you're going to do this now because I'm asking you. I don't care if you're stiff and unfit. You don't want to ask the horse to do something that they can't do. Ask her from this side. A little bit better. She kind of faded out on me. I'm going to intake in this rein and ask her in a walk. Good. Good girl. So I'm going to pop over the small jump twice. Two more times. I'm going to have a really exaggerated walk here. Nice working walk. And then I think I'm going to call it good for today just because the footing is really, really bad. And then I think tomorrow I will attempt to ride out on my little course right there. It just really depends because the footing in here is pretty bad, so I'm not sure that footing out there is going to be any better. Good girl. See, and I went over my horse. I jumped ahead of her and I came back too hard. That hurt my back for one, and I made her knock it in her back feet. So, instead of me waiting, I jumped ahead of my horse, which made her come off a little early. And then I sat down too fast, and it didn't feel nice. So I'm going to redo it, and I'm going to try to focus on myself and tell myself to wait, because I don't want to get into bad habits again this early in the year. Because that'll just piss my horse off, and we don't want to piss my horse off. I've halt. Much better. So I'm going to do that one more time, just because there, I waited a little bit too long. And I kind of felt the saddle bop me in the butt. And I don't want to get in bad habits. So one more time, and if it's good and I feel confident that we did it perfectly, I'm going to call it quits for today. And again, this is really hard with this hard footing, because she's kind of having to work harder just to get above everything. Easy. Good, that was perfect. There you go. Good, so I'm going to call it quits for today. And thank you for watching, like, and subscribe. I will try to make more videos again. Like I said, this footing right here is not ideal. If you see it, it's kind of sticking some parts. I got the two goofballs right there, being goofy. So it's really muddy right here. It's really slick right here. I got rocks everywhere that I need to pick up. So once the ground gets soft enough, well, not soft enough, but dry enough where I'm going to be able to take my drag and drag this out smooth and get all these big boulders out of the way again this year and hopefully get footing laid down, I'll be able to make more videos. So my drag sunk in. I'm going to have to undig that too. But as you can see, this footing is horrible. She's really schlooshing in there. I wonder, can you guys see how her feet are just sinking into this footing? So it's not ideal to work in, but we got it done. Oh, and I do have a neck strap here. I do not try to use it at all. It's basically just in case I need it. Again, I can't balance off her mouth because this is not the ideal bit for it. This is a stark naked bit. It is a new tradition from an old tradition, which is the Oliga Indian bridle, which was basically a loop around the horse's mouth. So it's old but new. It's a rustic, modern, old device. So again, I'm just gonna let her go, stretch out my legs. Now, if you guys, you know, have any questions, go ahead and leave them in the comment section down below, and I will answer them to the best of my capability. I do know some of this footage is not going to be on the video, except for the head cam POV with emptiness, but I'm going to try to line these up together perfectly. So you guys can see what I see and hear everything without me cutting off one video and then having it be all distorted and not right. So anyways, that's my thing. She's not hot or sweaty. Ooh. There we go. Ooh. There. Okay, let me see this. So, I want to thank you guys for watching, and I will talk to you guys later. And hopefully you guys have all a good day. Thank you for subbing. Sassy loves all our subbers. And, more videos to come, hopefully, if the weather's nice. I'm gonna go lay in the hot tub now with my back. So, bye guys. Stay on top. Helmets, heels down. You know, be safe out there.